If you're somebody that's looking to run profitable TikTok ads, today is the video where I'm going to be walking you through my exact strategy and campaigns to how we run six-figure TikTok campaigns and what it is that we've discovered after spending over $10 million on ads and how we have utilized some of these principles into our TikTok campaigns. And if you stay to the end of this video, I'm going to walk you through the exact thought process, the creatives, and ultimately, how do you create TikTok ads that is engaging, that your customers will thank you for, but also at the same time, generate massive leads and sales. Okay, so let's begin with the why. So as you probably know, if you're thinking about running TikTok ads, the one thing that I can assure you is that 100% your cost per lead is going to be lower than all other platforms, whether it's Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, cost per lead is the least. Now, for the longest time, I have thought that TikTok ads, I've resisted it because I thought it was just so many kids, it's people who are doing funny dance videos, they don't have money. And I gotta admit, I was wrong. And today in this video, I'm also going to hopefully prove to you why you should be paying attention to this platform because I do believe that this is still the early adopters stage. And as we all know, marketers will spoil everything, including myself. So you want to be able to at least try this for yourself and notice the difference in your market. So in terms of the creative section, I'm going to walk you through what we do in our campaigns and ultimately why this thing here is super crucial. Okay, so before I walk you through the exact thought process and to be able to create these ads together with you, the first thing that we want to be able to make it is to make it native. So what does this mean? It means that as you are creating this ad, and I would say this is probably one of the most important factors, okay? We want to be able to make this ad blend in with all of the other TikTok videos that they're used to seeing as they are going on TikTok, okay? So what does that mean? It means that you're not going to shoot this video in horizontal landscape mode. You're not going to cut a square out of it. You're not going to resize it anyway. You're going to shoot the video as though it was taken from your phone. Now, technically, you could use a camera and still have it cut out and edited if you want to make it fancy. But a lot of our videos, they're just shot from my normal phone over here because we want to make it look native. Native also means that you want to make it as though it's edited from the native TikTok app. Why? Because you want to make it so that it doesn't stand out as an ad, right? So what does this mean? It means that at the start, if you are creating this ad, you want the dimensions to be 9x16 and also 1080 multiplied by 1920, right? So that's the dimension of this video over here when you shoot this video. Okay, that's number one. So with that being the first factor, and before we create this ad together, let me walk you through three main factors first before we go shoot the video together, and hopefully you'll do it together with me so that you'll be able to kind of model my thought process and what it is that we do to roll these different ads out, okay? Number two, and that brings us to number two. So number two is about your choice of music or sound, okay? Now I'm going to walk you through the groundwork first and I'll give you a pro tip, okay? So what does this mean? We all know that TikTok is all about, right, your choice of music. Most people consume content on TikTok, even searching for the music to see what type of videos is trending based on that specific music. So when you are shooting an ad, it's very important to kind of realize what music is trending on TikTok right now. So here's how I think about it. I don't utilize TikTok to consume other people's stuff, but I have to admit, I use TikTok to get ideas on what type of music is trending. So if you are somebody that loves going on TikTok, as a way to get distracted looking at funny dance moves or viral cat dog videos, right now you have full permission, you have my permission to utilize TikTok to go and see and understand what's trending right now. Why? Because chances are you want to be able to utilize the trending music as part of your ad. Why? Because this doubles down as part of your ad, right, with this, which is point number one, making it look native. It looks like it's another video that's on TikTok that is trending or viral as a direct result of that, right? So as you are running this ad, if you execute this step well, what's going to ultimately happen is you're going to accumulate social proof, you're going to get the likes, the views, and it's going to look a lot more organic over time when you leave it running, right? So when you leave it running, when it's profitable, when it's getting you leads, when it's getting you sales, right? So that's number two, the sound and the music, right? I'm going to walk you through a thing and then we'll do it together. Now, pro tip over here. So what's this pro tip? Number three is, well, before I move on to number three. So one of the things that if you intend to take this ad and run it on other platforms, utilizing copyright music, how most platforms detect copyright music. Now, here's the thing, in black and white, you obviously can't use anything that is copyrighted, right? This includes logos, music, you know the drill, right? Now, here's the thing, okay? Now, if you were to write in to any of these platforms saying, can I use copyrighted stuff? Now, obviously, the answer is always no, right? Now, what does this mean? So, give me a second. I'll be right back. So, this means that if you were to go to Facebook and say, hey, I would love to be able to run an ad that utilizes this Iron Man helmet from Marvel. Do I have permission to do so? Guess what? The person behind the screen that works at Facebook, do you think this person is going to go through the trouble and say, well, this person is just going to outright say no, right? Now, I believe in asking for forgiveness than asking for permission. So what I would do is I would run this ad and put it this way. The line that I draw is as long as I am not utilizing content. So like, for example, the Iron Man logo or copyrighted logo Marvel, as though I'm affiliated with the company, that's where I draw the line, okay? So I have no issues ever, like running, utilizing these props from like Marvel, for example, in my ad, no problem with that. Now that's how I think about music as well. You see, when it comes to music, how these platforms work is they automatically have this automated filter to see if your content is utilizing music in order to allow this ad to run or not, okay? So this is where you can actually
distort it, okay, this is a pro tip over here, so that it passes through the filter.
Okay, let me give you an example. So for example, this is where I am going to bring up an ad that I utilize from TikTok where I utilize a segment of this. Okay, so let me just bring this up so that you know what I'm talking about. So here's an example of an ad that I utilize on TikTok, but I also take a variation of it and run it on other platforms like Facebook and Instagram. Just listen to this and you'll know what I mean. Here we go. Okay, so if you watch Marvel, you'll know that this music is from the Marvel's theme, right? The Avengers. If I were to utilize this segment here on, say, Facebook, it will automatically either get muted or rejected by the algorithm because it's copyrighted. So one thing that many top content creators do is they will distort it so that either there's a voice over it, so that it's
higher pitched, so it's
lower pitched,
but it's not gonna sound exactly the same in order to get past the algorithm that's automatically going to either mute it or filter it out. Okay, I want you to notice the amended version that is still running as an ad for me today. Okay, listen to this carefully and hear the difference. Okay, so just pause 1 second, okay? So this ad over here, you'll notice that it's a lot higher pitch, it's distorted, okay? So this is how like top creators go about this as well, right? In order to get past the filter, they either do a voice over it while utilizing the clip that they're referencing to. They will do in one way, shape, or form so that it's not the original one in the eyes of the algorithm. Okay, so like this ad over here, we probably launched about 1.5 years ago, and it's still up and running on these different platforms. Some of you might have even seen it before, right? Comment below if you have, right? So, but this is basically how you can utilize sound that is trending, that is viral, but still give the algorithm and the audience what it is that they want, okay? And that brings us to number three. So number three, once you have make it look native, right? As though everything's done on the app, make utilize music or sound that is trending. Number three, the third thing to think about is, well then, what's the hook? What's the pattern interrupt? What's gonna make people stay? And you want them to stay for at least 5 seconds, okay? At the very least. Why? Because that is when the button for your ad appears. So before 5 seconds, the buy now, learn more, shop now, whatever button that you might have on the ad, it doesn't appear until 5 seconds later. So one very important thing is you gotta think about is in your ad, how can you secure a person's attention? You could utilize a prop, it could be movement, it could be something that's interesting that makes a person wanna give you that initial first 3-5 seconds of attention, right? So what's the hook? Props are great, but music is great as well, especially if you're utilizing something that is trending, right? So let's take an example, okay? All right, so for example, a music that is trending right now and quite a while, like over a year, is this song, Oh No, right? So you can see like from this video over here, this video has got like 48 million views, 5 million views. So what I will do is I would always take a look and see like why are these videos getting like insane amount of views, because even though one very important thing that I do want to mention, guys, I am not a TikTok influencer. I'm not interested in building organic growth on TikTok. I probably have like 15 videos on TikTok, okay? I'm not about building organic following. I'm probably doing 0.0001% of what these TikTok influencers are doing. I'm not about building a following on TikTok. I am about building up a system and having the ability to spend $1 on these platforms so to get back $3 in return. Okay, that's what I specialize in. So I want you to understand a key difference. I'm not asking you to create these videos to go viral. I'm showing you here in this video of what it takes to create a good engaging ad on these platforms so that for every $1 you spend, you get back $3 in return, right? Net profit, right? That's the benchmark, that's the goal, right? Because if you can do that, that's how you can build a scalable business. All right, so let's take a look and see like what is this video that's got 15 million views all about. Okay, let's pause 1 second, okay? I want you to notice the tempo of the music. Right now, we are how many seconds in? Right, we are about, 6 seconds in? And nothing has happened yet. But I want you to notice how it feels. It feels like it's building up the crescendo. There's this climax where you know something's gonna happen based on the nature of the song itself. Here's what happens next. So notice something, like it doesn't even show you what happens, right? It was just to hook you to the end, and in fact, you don't have no idea what happens, right? So you can see that over here, the tap was switched on like 12 seconds in. Oh no. Right, 12 seconds in. Now, based on the nature of the song, it tells you that people are going to watch. Let's take a look at this Gordon Ramsay video, okay? All right, so I can't believe that we're here all, you know, watching TikTok videos together. But what does this tell you? This next video tells you that, again, you know, it's viral. Okay, so it's not about modeling what they're doing in here, but it's about understanding why these videos are viral and how if you utilize the context or the framework inside a ad, it's going to have a similar effect. Maybe not organically, but this is how it's going to retain a person's attention on that video a whole lot more, right? So utilize what's trending, music, right? So this is what we want. So for example, if I wanted to shoot an ad that utilizes this process based on what we've covered so far, this is what I'll do, okay? I am going to shoot it on this phone. And I am going to imagine that right now I'm going to TikTok. Okay, so all I'm going to do is I am going back to this cat video over here. And I am going to use this song, right? And I'm going to click on use this sound. And I want to be able to record this ad as though it's natively created in this TikTok app, because it is, right? So all ads, this is where I'm going to move back to the ad section. I'm going to shoot this thing first, and then I'm going to walk you through like how you run it, okay? So all ads, it ranges from, I would recommend from about 15 seconds to 45. You're allowed up to 60 seconds, okay? Doesn't need to be long. So remember, the theme, if I'm utilizing this music, is I want it to be able to look native. I want to utilize a sound that is trending, and post-edit, I might edit this sound so it's distorting it, right? So that it doesn't get in trouble with like Facebook if I'm utilizing it on a different platform. As well as making sure there's a hook, good hook or pattern interrupt. Now, so all I'm going to do is, guys, remember, doesn't need to be fancy. You might notice that one of the most viral videos on TikTok sometimes doesn't even make sense, right? Have you ever watched a video and like, why is this stupid video have like 3 million views and it's not even funny? Okay, it's all about outside of the box or being different. It could be weird, it could be eccentric, all right, whatever. That's what TikTok is about. Okay, so imagine if I'm running this right now and it would be like the oh no, right? I don't even have to say a word. You guys will be able to see the results of what happens with this ad. Okay, so it looks something like this. Okay, so this video so far, it's shot on the app, may not necessarily make sense. Why? Because post-edit, the team is going to make it so that at the end, like, oh no, what happened, right? So probably it's like, if this is an ad for me, it would be like, there's no sales, nothing happened, right? But the whole goal here is now to put text over this thing so that the story and the narrative and the call to action is on the text. Right, so maybe if I wanted to do this, if you think about this song, right, oh no, what is it? It's probably like a problem, right, a roadblock, something that went wrong, right? So maybe it would be like problem getting sales online, right? And then I check my laptop and then it just says like zero sales, right? That could be it. And then it would be diverting call to action, right? Click on this link, right, if you're facing similar problems, or depending on your funnel, right? If you're sending people free plus shipping, it could be like claim this free book to result. It could be if it's a webinar, it's a live, whatever it might be, right? You're sending people to your funnel. If it's a physical product funnel, same thing over here, right? But this is how I want to be able to train you to think about context, okay? So all I'm going to do is I'm going to click on next, okay? Now, the way to save your TikTok videos is you can publish it so that only you can see it. Okay, so one of the things that TikTok allows you to do is you can download the videos, but they want you to publish it first. So you can just go ahead and publish it. I'm just going to type in oh no over here, right? This is not going to be an actual post. All I'm going to do is I am going to post it, but only I can watch this video, right? So I'm going to post this and then it's published. Okay, so then the next thing I'm going to do is I am going to edit it. Well, I'm not going to personally do it. I'm just going to send it to my team. But basically, all they're going to do is they're going to add in the call-outs together with the call to action. And it's done. Okay, you'll see it right now. All right, so now that the video is edited, okay, notice there's a couple of things that we added to the video. Number one is, because I understand the button only appears 5 seconds, there's a hook that makes a person watch at least for 5 seconds, right? The next thing a call to action could do is you can ask people to swipe left, because by swiping left is a little bit weird, I know, from other platforms, but when they swipe left, that's kind of like clicking on it in order to go to your sales process or ad or shopping cart, right? So, or your funnel, right? So that's the call to action. Then notice another thing that we added is captions. I'm adding the captions, but I'm making the captions not fancy, but rather captions that look like captions inside TikTok, right? So it blends in natively. And ultimately, if you want to be able to see like the difference between this ad, ads on TikTok together with Facebook ads, we actually did a $10,000 experiment. Be sure to watch the recommended video at the end. And ultimately, if you think about like the different ad creatives that you'll be utilizing, here's what I'd like you to think about, okay? So this is just one out of many, right? The first one could be unboxing something. When a person unboxes a video, it looks like a natural thing that's native on the platform as well, right? A person just bought something. This could be your product. Number two could be like experiences that acts as like testimonial. So let's say if you're selling, you know, makeup, mascara, right? This is somebody applying it or demonstrating the use or the result of your product. And number three could be like riding on trends, which is like music or something that's viral, just like the one that I'm doing right now. That's pretty much it. This is how we create it or utilize this creative process. And after that, we run it onto our TikTok Ads Manager. If you have no idea how the TikTok Ads Manager is utilized, be sure to watch this other related video as well that's going to pop up right after this. Guys, if you've enjoyed this video, here's what I'd like you to do. Just comment below. Let me know what are your thoughts. If you enjoyed the video, if you didn't enjoy the video, smash the like button. This helps the channel out. And to be sure to subscribe to this channel for more videos just like this one. If you really want to get good at TikTok ads, be sure to watch our other videos where we experimented TikTok ads versus Facebook ads together with running Facebook ads as well as TikTok ads profitably by binge watching this entire playlist.